Today we will be talking about how to handle tiling textures when creating texture atlases. We recommend watching the Texture Baker Basics and Multiple Materials tutorials before watching this video. In this scene, we have a few objects that show the different ways to implement tiling in Unity. There are two ways that meshes can implement tiling. Material textures sometimes have tiling and offset applied. More commonly, we can scale the mesh UVs to be outside the range 0 to 1. Look at the UV layout of this model. The UVs extend beyond the bounds of the texture. The texture repeats to fill the UV bounds, creating a giant virtual texture. Mesh Baker can handle both types of tiling. Tiling will automatically be baked into the atlas for textures with tiling and offset. Let's try baking meshes that tile using out-of-bounds UVs. Notice what happens if we bake with the default settings. Large black areas and other textures from our atlas appear where they shouldn't. UVs that are outside the range 0 to 1 are leaking out of their rectangle and sampling other parts of the atlas. This is why our combined mesh shows black space and other textures instead of the virtually tiled texture. This problem can be fixed by checking the Consider Mesh UVs box in the Texture Baker settings. The Texture Baker will now calculate the area spanned by all mesh UVs and bake a block of tiling texture just large enough to contain the UVs. This block is copied to the atlas. In the atlas, the tiled texture has expanded to contain all of the UVs. This solution often works well, however, we need a different approach if the tiling is too big for your atlas. Baking tiling into atlases can take up a lot of space. Once an atlas is full, textures need to be scaled to fit, and textures may lose resolution. A block of tiled texture in the atlas will be limited by the max tiling bake size option in the Texture Baker settings. When this happens, you should use the Multiple Materials option, introduced in its own dedicated tutorial. By using the Multiple Materials feature, we can fix the resolution problem by mapping tiling textures to their own submesh. A single texture on a submesh means only one texture in the atlas. It may leak outside its atlas rectangle, but will only sample copies of itself. Consider mesh UVs should not be checked if there is only one material on a submesh. A good rule to follow is, for more than one material, check the Consider UVs box. For a single material, don't check Consider UVs. You can save time by using the Automatic Mappings button to automatically put tiling textures on their own submesh. This creates a lot of submeshes. Many of these tile, but only by a small amount. We can combine these together with other materials, and leave the textures with lots of tiling on their own submesh. This way, we can still combine materials while limiting the resolution loss from too much tiling. Each submesh adds a draw call, so we should only use this feature when necessary. In our example, we've created a combined mesh with 5 submeshes. The atlases look like this. 4 of these atlases have only one texture in them. These are textures that had a lot of tiling and were losing resolution in the main atlas. Note that sometimes meshes have a lot of tiling, but only in one direction. A common example is a tree trunk. It wraps the trunk in the X direction without tiling, and tiles repeatedly in the Y direction. These textures can share an atlas with other textures if they are arranged side by side horizontally and touch the top and bottom of the atlas. Mesh Baker includes 2 experimental texture packers that do this, but this feature is covered in its own video. Mesh Baker is available on the Unity Asset Store. You can also visit us at digitalopus.ca for more tips and resources for using Mesh Baker.